Finally tonight, a week that recognized some noteworthy accomplishments by women.
From today onward, March 12th will be Natalie Randolph Day in Washington, D.C. The city's mayor made the decision to honor the new varsity football coach of Calvin Coolidge High School. 29 years old, an athlete, a science teacher, and the only woman leading boys on the gridiron in any high school in the nation.
Thank you.
Randolph says she just wants to get on with it, coaching the game she loves to play and to coach. But the season's start is months away, so today is about handling an unexpected amount of attention.
As for the players, my main concern is to make sure that they're not overshadowed. I mean, I do know the fact that this is so new, but I don't want all the focus to be on me. I want to make sure that they shine. I want to make sure that my seniors get where they need to be.
This week saw other women making history, too. It started last Sunday when Kathryn Bigelow became the first woman ever to win an Oscar for directing.
It's the moment of a lifetime.
2 days later, women were shattering records. The University of Connecticut women's basketball team topped its own winning streak with a run of 72 games. Then the courageous women who flew for the Air Force in World War II. Their surviving members were honored Wednesday with the Congressional Gold Medal, 60 years after their service to the country. Deanie Parrish is one of them.
Thank you for this award. With humility, yet with a great sense of pride. Over 65 years ago, we each served our country without any expectations of recognition or glory. And we did it without compromising the values that we were taught as we grew up.
The achievements of women were also marked today at the United Nations by Secretary of State Hillary Clinton on the 15th anniversary of the World Conference on Women.
I know there are those, hard to believe, but there are those who still dispute the importance of women to local, national, and global progress. But the evidence is irrefutable. When women are free to develop their talents, all people benefit. We must declare with one voice that women's progress is human progress, and human progress is women's progress once and for all.
When it comes to progress on the football field, Natalie Randolph sees no difference between herself and all the other coaches across the country.
What coach doesn't want to win? I want to win. We all want to win. I think that's universal. I think that has nothing to do with whether I'm a woman or they're a man.
She said she does hope the attention she gets will inspire others to keep breaking new ground.